Good evening, boys and girls, freaks of the fright, maniacs of the macabre. This is your podcast, host of the most. Once again today, I have a very special and honored guest. Again, her name is Jaime Hill. She is a very well-talented actress. She does voiceovers. She's appeared in numerous independent films, and she is an all-around great person with an awesome personality. First of all, let me tell you a little bit about Jaime. She was born in Vancouver and raised throughout British Columbia. Her first memories of performing are in school plays, drama classes, and skits in her living room in front of family members. Her training started at the age of 15 with representation by Charles Stewart International and workshops through New Image College. Nowadays, she does it all. She is a jack of all trades. She wears many hats. She's an actor, an advocate, craft services, and PA. She spends most of her time and energy supporting others in so many wonderful ways. Her quirky demeanor and squeaky voice has led her to many opportunities in the comedy field. She has four episodes on the web show Chew on This. She volunteers as a scare actor at the Rutherford Manor Haunted House every Halloween. Money is raised for the local food bank and animal rescue. Her first feature film was in comedy. The Hot Box, written and directed by Brandon Rhines. I think that's how you pronounce his name. Her giggling can be heard on I'm Haunted, another unique piece written by the same individual. And Grotesque was completed throughout the last 3 years. In 2022, Jamie worked with Kyle Ball as the mom in Skinamarink. Now, I've watched Grotesque. It is a very, very good movie. It has opened my mind to a lot of independent films now, which I'm very grateful. So, Jaime Hill, everybody, how you doing?
Hi, everybody. I'm very well, thank you. And yes, this is my real voice.
So I must admit, after watching Grotesque, I loved it. It was like one of the perfect independent films ever I've ever seen. I mean, the acting was great. The dialogue, it was all phenomenal. And your character cracked me up. I loved it.
Yeah, he's a little funny.
And the new movie coming out, Skinamarink, just got picked up by Shudder. Congratulations. That is a huge achievement. I am very proud and I'm happy for you and everyone else who's involved. So, what can you tell us, if you can, about the movie Skinamarink?
Well, I can tell you what it's about. It's about two kids. Lucas is the little boy. He plays a 4-year-old, and Delia Rose, she plays the big sister. She's six. Lucas's dad, Ross, actually plays the dad in the film, and I am the mom in the film. These kids are in Kyle's actual house that he grew up in. So his nightmares are brought from his past. And this is something he brought me into. Basically, I'm being the mother role in that house story, and it was a nightmare. And I can relate to those stories. So I love the idea. It's dark, scary things, and they still scare me. So this movie hit home for me. It's not everybody's cup of tea. It's a long film that keeps you on your edge, and you're looking, and you're always questioning. And if you like that kind of thing, then you're gonna love it. Jump scares are my favorite thing. Always glad that I don't have a cup of tea in my mouth, or maybe popcorn that would fly everywhere, because some of them you don't expect to happen. So just beware what you're holding.
Especially a cup of hot tea.
Yeah.
So, as I've told you before, after I watched the trailer, I think for about 20 minutes, every time I heard a noise in my room or downstairs, I'm like, what was that?
Does. And that's what I'm really getting from the feedback, is it lingers. The film is about an atmosphere and a feeling, and I think films are meant to make you feel. I'm all about emoting, either whether it's comedy and I'm making people laugh, or if I'm in a haunted house like a witch and I'm cackling and scaring them, I make people feel. And I'm an empath, so when I'm feeling, I really take from my history and my area, wherever space I'm in, and it just make it real. And I knew what Kyle was going for. So we had a lot of fun. There was a small crew. Jaime did a great job, two Jaimes. Jaime was a cinematographer, and we were a small crew in the bedroom. So Kyle was the director, and that's all. There was just the three of us because there was not a lot of space. And we had a lot of fun filming. It only took the afternoon. It was a while back now. COVID was difficult. We did our best to keep our space. We did our best to use hand sanitizers and stuff and masks. And then when we were ready to film, we just took our masks off. But it was a lot of fun. Definitely.
I am so looking forward to seeing this movie because I love horror movies that have that psychological mind spank to it. This is what it looks like it's going to be. And I'll just watch the show. I'm grasping. I'm like, oh my God, this is going to be so good. So, now, is it a full length movie or is it a short?
It's a full length feature. It's 100 minutes. I have ADHD, so it's hard for me to keep my attention. But that saying, I did watch and then have to stop and go into the bathroom or whatever. So my attention was broken, but I would always recommend wearing a headset and watch it in the dark because your eyes adjust in the dark. Even the Christmas tree lights made a difference. So to make it more authentic, sitting in the dark is definitely recommended.
I may not want to watch in the dark. I'm just saying.
Just put a pillow in front of you. You're okay. Don't worry, I won't come through the screen. I promise.
I hope not. I'm like a ring or something. There's Sudoku coming through.
Watch your ears. It's also auditory.
Okay.
So it's not just visual. So there's like a crackling from the TV. Okay. I'm born in the 70s. So when I was young, the TV made crackly noises and a wee with lights, like stripes. And, you know, that's what CBC did. And that's just how things went in Canada when I was a kid. Our three channels made a funny noise until the channels came on in the morning. Well, that really hits home on my childhood because we would go watch cartoons and we would wait. And it was dark. And well, I have a good imagination, and my brother and I would scare each other because that's just something we enjoyed doing. That's probably where it started. My brother and I scared ourselves when we were young, and then I'm a haunter, and then now I enjoy scaring people in film.
I feel the same way. As I told you, I worked at the Valley of Fear as a haunter, and my character was a butcher. So, and my supervisor told me, "Okay, this is something I'm handing over to you. You have to develop this character, come up with a whole persona." So I did. I went to Spirit Halloween store and bought a burlap pig mask to wear over. And I nicknamed my character Porkchop. So that's what I called him. So it was Porkchop the Butcher. Like
Porkchop. We have a pig man. And we tease him and call him Porkchop. Which
Hold
is
on,
funny.
See if
fun.
You see the mask. Oh, it's right
there. Oh, I do see it. Yeah. Oh, those are a lot of tusks. Yeah, that's a.
Yeah, that was the guy I had to develop, and it came out so well. I actually grew a fan base the 2 weeks I was working there. After 2 weeks, I came up with this guy. I grew a fan base on social media.
That's
it was
cool.
Pretty awesome because people come just like before they get to my because they knew where I was gonna be, but they didn't know where I was gonna jump out at. But they come up on wagons, I can hear them chanting, "Pork chop, pork chop, pork chop." I'm like, oh my goodness, they're chanting my name. So yeah, it was a really cool experience. So yeah, I get it. I love, I working at the haunt, I developed I guess it's a hobby now. So whenever I move somewhere else, I'm going to look for another haunt to work at.
Yes. Yep. Edmonton's been a lot of fun for different haunts. But Rutherford Manor has been the most fun. We do it all out of volunteering. And most of the time, I don't have a mask on at all. It's just me painted up and makeup and, you know, cackling. Because if you listen to my audiobook from Mark Redfield, Frankenstein Mobster. You hear my cackle, and I could possibly cackle as long as I don't make my dog bark. But everybody watch their ears, because I do love my cackle, and I'll show it to you in 2 seconds.
Yeah, that would scare some kids.
Right? It was fun. So I had little kids running up to me. It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. And, you know, their parents had fun because I kept them busy in the line. The lineups were an hour or two.
Really?
They were long. Wow. Yeah. And I walked the line to help entertain everybody because, you know, I'm an entertainer. I'm not just a scare actor. Once after the first year, they realized I'm good with the people. They put me in the line to talk to people. So
it
made
awesome.
It even more fun. Yeah. So I got
I'm sure it did. That sounds awesome. So aside from like Skinamarink and Grotesque, what other films have you been in that you could brag about?
Well, you mentioned Brandon Reines. We did Hot Box, I'm Haunted, I Giggle. My mom is also in that movie. It's a family affair now. My husband haunts with me. So we do things together. My family's also in Grotesque. You'll see their faces on a magazine. It's my mom and my husband's faces are actually on the magazine that Mildred
really?
Is reading. Yeah,
that's so
I'll
cool.
Show you a picture. So working with Brandon is most likely something in the future. You know, we had a lot of fun working together. Indie film is a really close-knit thing in Edmonton. So we make a good team, and we usually stick together through more and more multiple films. So I'd be waiting and watching for more from Brandon. I did a recent film, Good Arson. That's going to be coming out, and I'm not a happy camper like in Grotesque. I yell and I'm mean. I'm angry. So you see a different side of me, which I'm really excited about. And of course, you're still going to see me in comedy because that's the thing I really like to do. I have two scripts on the go, working on getting those things read and worked on by the right people, and that's in the future. So it's not just acting. Voiceover is my other thing. The Witch was just The Haunted House.
But I like to sound like Venellope from Wreck-It Ralph, and I guess sometimes I sound like Sarah Silverman. And I could sound like an old lady from an old lady store. But, you know, when you want to buy some old shoes, it's just been a lot of fun. I made lots of different funny noises when I was a kid. And we would just play games to make each other laugh. And I had little stuffed animals that, you know, we would play school. And they would be my students with my poor brother. I made him play all these games. I line him up with my stuffed animals and teach school. And I've always been someone to teach and advocate and to learn. So I just kept on going. I'm 45. I will be 46 next February. I'm not embarrassed about that. I don't sound like it, so it's almost frustrating. I'll keep on going. I just started acting again. I started when I was 15. I moved away. In the 90s, you couldn't really keep acting, and it didn't work that way. So now that my kids are all grown up, they're in their 20s, I'm going to be a grandma next year. I'm doing and following my stars. And lo and behold, Skinamarink is announced coming out on Shudder and going into theaters, and AMC's talking all about it. And I'm ecstatic. I follow my dream. I ask God to just let me go. And I believe in a higher spirit. I was just praying to whoever to let me have that dream and follow that to get the strength for it. And it happened. So thank you, whoever my higher power is. You know, I talk to my dad and my brother. They're both passed away. And I ask them all the time to give me the strength for that. So maybe it was them. Who knows? But if you're wanting to get into film and you want to be funny, or you want to be a scare actor or whatever, don't be afraid to take the steps to do it. Because you never know. You might end up in Variety magazine online.
That is fantastic. Obviously, you're very talented and you're well achieved. And I congratulate you on everything that you've done so far. Just
Thank you.
please don't tell me your birthday is February 19th because that'd be so weird.
18.
Day before mine.
You're a Pisces.
Yes.
Well, you're like total on the line. I thought I was on the line. Whoa, that's still scary. We like horror. So my husband's also in February. He's only a few days before mine. So we have a great plan for this year. We'll be flying out to Nova Scotia to meet our granddaughter.
I've been there. I've been to Halifax. It is a fantastic place to go to.
It is. I went to Dalhousie School, School of Nursing. Started out as a nursing student, and then ended up being an actor.
Follow your dreams. That's what everybody keeps saying. And you did it, obviously. And you did it so well. So, and yes, you are a phenomenal actress. And I'm gonna, you hear that, public? She is phenomenal. I don't care what you think.
Thank you. I just like making people laugh or I guess cry.
Either
Expanding.
way, everyone loves you. I mean, you have that personality that you are the lovable character. You are the
I
lovable
love
person.
it. Yeah.
And talking to you, I like you a lot just by I don't even hardly even know you. So
Thank you. Yes. And I get that from many people. And that's why I enjoy being an advocate. I worked in mental health as a psychiatric aide. Didn't like the nursing thing. I wanted to work one-on-one with people. Mental health is a lot about nightmares. So I let
it
people
is.
talk
It is.
and,
Being a military veteran, I have been diagnosed with PTSD and I have been diagnosed as clinically depressed and I have anxiety. And but the VA is taking care of me. So I'm taking medications every day. I got my dogs, I got my cat, I got my wife. They all help me. So yeah.
Yes, I have a dog. Needless to say, he's always here. He's on my lap constantly. When I'm stressed, he's my go-to. So definitely, pets are a miracle. They really
Yes,
are.
my dog River. She is a half German Shepherd and a half Mini Collie mix. I don't know how that happened, but she is the cutest thing in the world. So, and she picks up on my stress, my anxiety as well too. So she'll
It
start licking my face, and I'll play with her, and I'm calmed down. I'm calm right away. So, it's a great thing.
Yeah, I felt that they feel our pain when I was practicing and auditioning for the role for Good Arson. Toki actually peed on the floor.
Oh
I scared him. Yeah,
no.
his name is Tokala because he looks like a fox, right? So he just wants to cuddle. He's like a little baby. Yeah, Tokala is also a movie star now. He's in some media with my mom for Astor Gardens in Edmonton. Optimal Living has lots of little clips of my mom and my dog. So we're all a family affair, not just humans, the dog too.
So before we wrap this up, is there anything that you would like to tell your fans out there? Anything at all? It could improvise, whatever. Say what you want to say.
I would say thank you for your love and thank you for keeping up with my advocacy for everyone's mental health because the biggest thing I advocate for is mental health, especially in film. Everybody's got to have relationships that are healthy for them. And if they're not, there's always ways to help change that. Whether you're laughing or you're crying, those are emotions that come out. Film has definitely changed my perspective on how well I can help others. I can make them laugh or cry, and I'm flabbergasted at everyone's comments on how I can make them feel. So thank you. I try my best. So I'm Jaime Hill, and like on Clubhouse, which is where my voiceover and everything really started going. I'm dropping the mic and I'm going to go make some spaghetti. And I look forward to seeing you guys in January for this Skinamarink on Shutter.
Definitely keep an eye on that. Wise words for a wise woman. You hear that, people? Okay. Thank you so much for your time. I really do appreciate it. You are a very awesome person. And I will be looking forward to watching Skinamarink. And I am going to check out the rest of your movies just because you're an awesome brand.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll
And
talk soon.
I bid you adieu and have a very good evening. It's been really nice talking to you.
You too, Ben. Bye,
All right.
everybody.
Bye-bye.
In this house. In this house. In this house. In this house. In this house.